There's no place to escape to.
This is the last street.
On the left.
That's when the cannibalism started.
What was that?
Great.
Welcome to the last stream on the left, everyone. Happy Tuesday.
Tuesday. Yes. Twin Peaks, wear my Twin Peaks shirt because of my two beautiful pert breasts.
That's what that show is all about. This is fun.
No, we learned actually the opposite this week on this episode of Men in Black. When we were talking about how Twin Peaks actually is a secret cover-up, technically something akin to the secret school's parables that were supposed to teach us about what was really happening in concurrence with our past involving creatures from the stars.
Want to thank everyone who came out to our Portland show. Really nice time. We had a great weekend in Portland. Thanks to everyone who came out. It was an old high school.
It was great.
So that was like weird. We all had PTSD immediately of getting shoved in lockers and stuff like that. So yeah. I was always too big to get shoved into the locker. So,
yeah, that's the best part about your gigantism is that really kept you from being bullied.
No, it didn't keep me from being bullied. It kept me from being specifically shoved into lockers because that's a small man's bullying.
Yeah, man. Yeah, it's true. You see, what I do as a small man, what you got to do is get in a man's head.
Yeah, yeah. And then you got to get 18 of you, and then you take a person down at the knees. That's a good professional wrestling trick. And then you just torture them.
You don't think, I don't know, five other guys my same fucking size, same level of rage, not ready to circle around you in a fucking bowl circle, ready to take you down?
No, I know. That's exactly what I'm saying. That was the PTSD that I had. Yeah, they're all violent.
Oh, yeah, right.
Anyone under 5'8 is violent.
Look how fast that is. Like,
you are fast.
Well, it's my mandate this week.
Yes, it's true.
And as was discussed last week when we saw the trailer for the Peter Boyle vehicle Puchinski, we decided that we were going to spend the first part of this episode watching the entirety of Puchinski.
Woo! I can't wait.
I'm excited to see what this. Now, okay, so who else is in this show?
I don't know.
You did not, so you don't know. We don't know who the love interest is. Is he going to be fucking a dog in this?
No, he can't. Well, the dog can't have a love interest.
No, but he has a sidekick.
Okay.
Yeah, and the sidekick, who is the sidekick, Travis? Because it's possible he has a love interest because it was only a pilot,
honestly,
so it
though,
never went to series. So I'd imagine that the sidekick had a love interest like three episodes in, but he had to hide the fact that his dog was also his dead partner, and then all sorts of shenanigans.
But there's it's actually a really hellish situation to be put into a dog because you can't have sex with a human anymore, and you really can't have sex with a dog.
You can.
You know what you're doing. You're a person of mind.
Yeah, but so you're saying it becomes legal the more simple you are as a person?
No. It has the mind of a man. You know of a dog, but he can't. But
yeah, if it's got a dog's fucking pussy and it's got a human's mind, you're allowed to fuck it if it says yes. Yeah.
No, I know. Yeah, but he's still a man now having sex with a dog, even though he is technically a dog.
But he might be influenced by the loins of the dog. Like, say, if he goes into the dog, he probably has the instincts of the dog. These are all questions that could be answered when we watch the pilot.
I imagine that the Fox pilot Puchinski asks a lot of the hard questions of, like, if it's a dog's cock but it's a man's mind, if he shoves it in a woman's pussy, is it bestiality?
Those are the questions we have to ask you. Remember, a long time ago, dogs were cops. That was a fun time.
They were. Asking, Viola Lucas is asking, will you guys have a Chuckle Hut audience area at the stream at SDCC? We will be. There will be an audience.
Yes,
so you can be there, and you can technically yell at us.
Yes. Yeah, I can't wait. That's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to show some cool videos.
Now you're talking.
Travis, did you ever find out who the sidekick is?
Do you want the actor?
Yeah.
George Newbern.
Great guy. George Newbern.
Oh,
good
love
thing I know
George
that now.
Newbern. I believe he's been Me Too'd. He's one of them.
George Newbern.
But when they don't care about the actor, it's a Me What? Or a who now?
Now, I don't know who, which one is the sidekick. We got Sergeant Shriver, Captain Ed Martin, and Detective Robert McKay. I'm sure any of those could be the sidekick.
They better be. Is any one of them from also previously from Cheers? Are we looking at John Radnitsky?
Which one is John Radnitsky?
John Radzinski?
Radnitsky?
Isn't that Cliff?
Is that Cliff?
Ratzinger.
I love Cliff. He's also a funny character in Toy Story.
Mm. And also in Empire Strikes Back.
Nah.
Nope.
No. All right, so are we ready to start this? We're going to watch this for a while.
Well, yeah.
And see how long we last
like every
with it.
3 minutes,
yeah, we're going to last.
We'll see,
yeah.
You know.
It might just be really bad. Oh, they really jump right in.
Yes, it is very bad.
Proceed to magnitude savings. Interrogate another Inchpatello robbery victim.
Hey, in the bathroom, he's Poopchinsky.
You will never have a show in TBS. That's all I hear whenever I hear one of those shows.
Very funny.
Hey, how do you know who I am?
This is from Naked Gun. That's amazing.
Yes, that's stolen, yeah.
I'm really hoping that
Puchinsky, the very beginning, does not accidentally kill a black man by trying to subdue him.
Build any distinctive features, sir.
Yeah, he had a gun in my ribs. 25 minutes it took you to get here. What kept you a long line at Mr. Donuts?
Oh, roast mode. Do not treat young Frankenstein like that.
Four people. It took four people to make this. Dark anymore. That guy.
You know, Puchinsky, I've been covering you for a month. I'm sick of it.
Uh-oh.
We see in that.
Seems like an eternity.
What? Come on. Quit being grumpy.
Zing, pop.
Quit being grumpy while you still got a human dick, Peter Boyle.
Oh, I love a bold cop walking around eating hot dogs.
What's it to you, Grandpa?
Whoa. Yeah, fucking kid with a knife.
Head, you know, when you get to be my age, you forget things like whether or not this gun is loaded.
Yeah, fuck yes. Shoot him in the head, man. Start this out correct.
Oh, God. A lot of cops were inspired to become cops by watching this. You can tell.
My father was one.
Don't be afraid.
Oh, this is only a gun.
Come here, let me see. Here, homie. Right, like here. Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, that's what I do. One for you, one for me.
Hey, give me a kiss. Come on.
Oh, buddy, come on now. You don't really know this dog.
Oh, now, don't you fuck that dog right now, Peter Boyle. Yeah, maybe that's why.
They're coming up to the bestiality thing a little bit different than I thought they were going to.
Yeah, I got very real, man.
Wow.
If you insist on bringing that thing along, you can at least bathe it.
Oh, you know nothing about bulldogs? That's the way they always smell. Come on, try this one, boy. You wear this, and believe me, no one's gonna try to eat out of your bowl, okay? Give me a kiss.
Oh, God, he keeps kissing him on the mouth. Yeah. I kiss just Wendy. I don't kiss Wendy right on the back. Mouth. I kiss Wendy on the sides of the face.
Finally found someone to kiss you?
I guess so, yeah.
Yeah, because I could force this one.
Around. I wouldn't want anyone to think I've been unfaithful to your wife.
Oh! There's a lot of roasting going on.
This guy is very funny. This guy's a stand-up comedian that's done a bunch of shit. Oh, I love this guy too.
On what grounds?
Partner incompatibility.
What is it?
Well, it's when you don't get along with your partner, sir.
I know what it means.
Oh, I remember this guy.
Exactly. What is the problem?
Irregular work habits.
I think he was on 227.
Blatant disregard for rules, and he has adopted this mongrel he keeps in the back seat.
Why do you hate dogs so much, you fucking Nazi?
He breaks wind constantly.
The dog.
Sergeant Puchinsky.
You alt-right motherfucker, you can't stand a dog being in the car, you piece
Detective,
of shit.
Who caught the North Hill Strangler? Who caught the post office bomber?
Puchinsky.
Don't confuse hygiene with character. There's
right,
a lot you can learn from a man like Stanley Puchinsky. And I suggest you start your education immediately.
Yes, sir.
Everybody loves somebody sometimes.
New Yorkers be so cool, man.
Yeah.
Everybody
cops having sex with dogs.
That's how it was,
partners
man.
Fighting.
We had free cable. We had free cable. My father could pull fireworks from the evidence table, and we could have sex with any dog we wanted in the neighborhood.
For God's sakes, this is a stakeout.
Here, you want to see a picture
Lyle
of my
Lyle Chipperson,
latest?
Yes, that was the chief from Last
nice,
Action
huh?
Hero. Good call.
You get to meet a lot of great broads when you work vice.
Lovely.
Predatory policing.
Lots of friends would like to meet a guy in line for a pension.
Thank you, but I'm sort of seeing someone now.
Who?
There's this woman, Franny. She's a widow, and she lives in my building with her little girl.
So how long have you and the merry widow been going out?
No. We haven't actually gone out yet. I just sort of see her around the building.
Hey!
I watched her.
You guys want to stake out?
It's Tiger Woods!
1734.
Oh, yeah, I'm a little bit short. Can you spare a few bucks?
Yeah, fine.
Yeah. There you go, kid.
Wow! Thanks, Mr.
Hey!
Whoa.
This isn't what I ordered. What kind of idiot? Look at this garbage. Shrimp and pineapple.
Shrimp and pineapple?
Like actually, it doesn't sound bad.
I'm starved.
Yeah, it does.
You're gonna get me another pizza.
I would eat that in a second.
No, I know
shrimp
that.
Is actually nice. We have a nice fish with like a salsa, like a pineapple mango salsa.
We've got a job to do.
Look, who died and made you Joe Friday?
All right, you know, I'm not glad
anymore. Good drain, that reference.
Uh-oh. Hey, now look what you did.
Oh, please.
Not sure how he had anything to do with that.
Hey, if he would have just let Puchinsky be Puchinsky, then he was right.
Casey.
I love how he's not running.
He doesn't have to run, man. He's got the walkie-talkie. Walkie-talkie makes running go faster with the sound.
Uh-oh. Puchinsky's gonna save him.
Oh my god, I'd love to see. Oh my god, if fucking Puchinsky like has a whip that can like allow him to like pull himself up onto a fire escape and then Peter Boyle's running across roofs and shit, I would watch the show alone just for that.
Hey, get out of this street, you crazy
man!
Oh,
he's gonna save the puppy!
Oh my god! Oh, he's still alive.
Okay. My wallet. Get my wallet. Don't talk. Cub tickets. Box seats. Take a date.
Wow.
Officer down on the corner of Clark and Diversey.
Good to know.
Right. Send help immediately. Repeat, officer down on the corner of Clark and Diversey. Send ambulance.
People don't.
I love you so much.
What?
Yeah, give it to me, Daddy. I miss you every day. I miss you when I'm here.
This is very romantic.
Here he
was. Oh, no. All right. And he goes. Doing what he loves. Sexually staring at a dog.
So I said, this is this, you know what turns out is that this is what actually would happen is that in this the world of Puchinsky, there is no heaven, there's only hell. And if your body, if your soul does not jump into a dog when you die, then it goes straight to hell.
Hey, we need more dogs around then. So does that mean that the dog's soul,
I think,
just
disappears
nowhere?
It went nowhere.
Yeah, let's pause it right here. Because I've got questions.
There's a lot to unpack there. A lot to unpack.
Okay, so does this mean that when Puchinsky's soul obviously went into the dog's body, did the dog give up his own soul? Where did the dog's soul go?
So a dog has no agency. That's what the first thing that Puchinsky has shown is a dog has no agency. It's not allowed to choose anything for its own. Its soul was pushed out its ass.
I don't know.
Because
I think that all dogs go to heaven. So I think they got a free pass. I don't think they even need the soul.
I mean, unless you're an atheist dog. Or maybe you're not one of the very 170,000 Mormon dogs that are only allowed to go to heaven. My problem is that with something, my main question is, does when the soul goes into the dog, does it go through the eyes or does it go through the mouth?
It went through the eyes. It obviously went through the eyes.
It seemed like that anyway. But I just think there were some strong problems with their policing overall. A lot of gunfire, a lot of pulling guns on children, and that's just not even counting the
kid and a knife.
Kissing. Yeah, but I mean, it was still just a kid.
However, Puchinsky did capture the Northside Strangler and the post office bomber.
Yeah, yes. That's very true.
That's so big, man. That's very, very difficult. And then you go, like, think about the kind of legwork that it took. That's why he doesn't run anymore, because his leg's been tired, right?
Yeah.
And then he's got this.
Don't you get to retire? If you capture one of like the big serial killers, you just get to retire, don't you?
Sometimes, not
yeah,
all
I
the
think
time.
So.
My father, that actually happened with him, is that he accidentally caught a man wanted in three states for pulling him over for a traffic violation, and then he tried to run, and because, like all Zabrowskis, we're the fastest people you'll ever meet within 10 feet. He fucking nabbed them in a dash, right? Got it, they pulled him down, and then he got arrested, and then they were like, so what we'll do is, all right, here's your commendations. You know, you got all these awards.
Oh.
Like, what we can do is it's like, we got to keep you on the beat. Or, I mean, you're not going to want this, but we could give you a desk job. Desk job, I'll take the desk job.
I love that your father was trying to get out of being a cop the entire time he was a cop.
Oh, yeah, buddy. That's like,
what
that's
a nightmare.
What you did, man.
Yeah, but, of course.
So now Peter Boyle's soul is trapped in the dog.
Yeah, I think that's what's just happened.
I don't know. I mean, trapped implies that his soul didn't want to go into the dog. Why and from what have? We've seen from the trailer, he very much enjoyed his soul being inside the dog.
I wonder if he legitimately thought it was because then he just feels like he could get away with a lot more crooked-ass stuff with broads as a dog.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. He's a controversial guy. Peter Boyle.
Well, you think also, well, I imagine there's going to be more things that are going to be described later on in the show once the lore gets out, once we get into the the show Bible of the show.
Yeah.
I totally trust the writers to really unpack all of this in a rational, reasonable way that's not going to lead us down a road of total confusion.
No way. But I imagine that the dog's personality has been pushed to the back, sort of like in the movie Split or like one of those they talk about multiple personality people where the main personality, the Peter Boyle personality's in the front, and then the dog's in the back.
Yeah. It didn't seem like the dog had that much of a personality.
Oh, the dog had a ton of personality. Did you see?
I couldn't make it out because Peter Boyle was constantly trying to have sex with it the whole time.
When Peter Boyle was singing, the dog was in the back going, oh, I don't like that song.
The dog is in the sunken place. Like, and get out.
Oh, yeah.
So it's screaming internally.
Poor dog. The dog fucking killed every cop it ever came across until it met Peter Boyle, and then this time, for some reason, it worked.
Maybe. I wonder if Adam Sandler was inspired by this for Little Nicky. Remember that talking dog?
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Let me tweet at him.
Yeah, tweet at him. Happy Madison. All right, should we continue this thing?
Let's continue with the funeral.
I want to see more of this.
Whew. Yeah, this is the funeral of Puchinsky.
I'm pretty invested now.
Oh, yeah.
No one's there.
Boy, you really they disappeared.
Who said that?
Short memory. It's your partner, Puchinsky.
Oh, my God.
Wow, they don't even really...
Surprise!
I don't. Wow, they jump right into that.
Wow.
Puchinsky will be right back.
I like
back.
The dog paws. I really do like the two paws.
It's a totally different location.
I'm going over the edge. You're not real.
You want proof? My badge number is 309. You've got a card in your wallet that tells you how much to tip. Last Friday you said the sports coat I was wearing looked like the tablecloth in an Italian restaurant.
Rosemode.
What do I gotta do to convince you? Everybody loves somebody sometime. Everybody falls in love somehow.
Puchinsky,
is he cool with
you
it?
Become a dog?
I guess.
All I know is I saw this big tunnel and this big shaft of light, and I heard voices at the end of it. Relatives' voices. And they were calling, here boy, come on, come on. And next thing I knew, I had a tail.
This is amazing.
He had to audition for this, you know?
Yo, Peter Boyle, this is an offer.
What's wrong with being a
dog? Oh, this is an offer? Okay.
You can take a nap anytime you want. You see a girl you like, you don't have to bother with small talk.
I think you were right on that take.
Well, first I'm going to try and break myself. And then I'm going to catch my killer. And you're going to help.
You can forget that. I'm off the case, and you're... Whatever you are.
He's a dog.
You're off the case.
Captain put me on a desk.
A desk? Your partner was murdered and you sat down.
That's a vacation.
Excuse me.
What are you doing? You're going to make yourself sick.
Exactly.
Uh-oh. Oh, my God.
Spare me the
trauma, Puchinsky. What's he doing? He's gonna take a dump.
I'm concerned.
So, McKay, who's heading the investigation?
Sergeant Shriver. Shriver. Shriver? Shriver couldn't find a stick in a popsicle.
That's right.
Yeah.
All right. Everybody's jumping into this real easy.
Yeah.
Put her there, pal.
Fuck yeah, Puchinski playing the guitar.
Great to be back.
No one said a fucking thing about this. He is not concerned about being a dog anymore. He's not having a deep personal crisis.
Really? I don't see how you can stand to be around a kisser like that.
He's a brilliant conversationalist.
Hey, do yourself a favor. I know this little restaurant downtown that pays $5 a pound.
That's racist. That's racist.
Oh!
Puchinski.
Puchinski.
That's all he does, man.
I see your aim's improved.
Look at that. Looks very unhealthy.
Yeah. Proceed with caution.
Hello, Casey. Would you mind watching this little fella for a few minutes?
Oh, God.
This might be a problem.
I always liked her. She's always, oh man, because he's had probably a lot of citations involving her in the past as a human. I can't imagine what it's going to be like as a dog when he can't control his erection.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Honestly, I was really joking about the dogs, but then it's a lot of that.
Wow. Why is he so happy? Puchinski's been dead 3 days.
Save it, son. You had a shock. The best thing for you to do is to go home. Take a few days off. Collect your thoughts.
No, sir. The best thing I can do is to catch my partner's killer.
Jesus Christ! What is happening?
Oh, my God. No, don't let her fuck that.
No, he already did. It's done, and apparently that's okay.
That's okay. And fuck that woman. If she came all over again.
Yikes. Hi, Robert.
Hi, Franny. These times, man. Hi, Katie. Used to be pure.
People Mom, really look!
Careful, he's not very friendly.
Is that,
What's his name?
What's your name from Robin Hood Men and Tights?
That's an excellent name for a dog.
Amy Yazbeck.
I didn't know you had a dog.
Yeah, she's a problem child.
Sit. Stay.
She's also from Men and Tights.
Who's my partners?
Yeah. Oh, I heard about that. I'm sorry.
You don't know the half of it.
You and Stanley are welcome to join us for dinner.
I'm really not up to having company right now.
Oh, he's a wingman. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, he knows how to lose somebody. His buddy's fucking he'll be next.
Do you want to live with you, Mr. McKay?
He actually haven't discussed it yet.
Bye, Robert. Bye, Stanley Kuczynski.
What's with you, McKay? The baby issue out for dinner and you make with the excuses. Do I have my work cut out for me?
Why is it your job?
He's your
getting
dog.
Him laid, Puchinski.
What else is he gonna do?
He should find his killer.
What are you doing that for?
Beats me. I can't even figure out how I keep my balance when I lift my leg.
Up, not on the...
I don't even think that's Peter Boyle's voice anymore. Honestly, I think it's somebody who's just doing it for him.
He also likes cartoons.
This couch is about as comfortable as a slab at the morgue.
Excuse me?
You should know.
Unless you're going to charge an enormous stud fee for me, you don't expect me to keep payments on my place, do you? Don't worry, I'll be out of here as soon as we wrap up this case.
Stone put me on the investigation. He did not mention anything about working with a bulldog.
What?
No, of course
don't
you didn't.
Don't call me that.
Why not? Look at yourself. You're a dog.
I'm a cop.
Yeah.
I need to remind you who bought the Northwest Bank or the post office bomber.
That's when you were making calls, not wearing one.
I'm a better cop with four legs than you'll ever be with two.
Okay, that's it. If you're such
I'm taking you to the vet to be put to sleep.
You don't have any trouble finding a new place to live.
You sent a poor helpless animal out on the streets alone?
Of course not.
Nobody pushes Stan Puchinski around.
Oh my
wow.
God.
All
right, do we want to pause and unpack for a
let's
second?
Pause.
What's going on?
We're pausing here. Pants Anthony on the stream says, imagine if Marcus's soul entered his dog and you had to take care of him forever. Then you have to pick up Marcus's poopies, and I would.
Thank you, Henry. I would as well.
If you jumped into a dog, man, oh man, we'd have so much fun.
We really
because
would.
We walk around, we joke around. You know what I mean? Like, you know, you'd be sitting there. I'd have to put you out of the room when I make love, like I have to do with Wendy. You and Wendy would be close.
I'd appreciate it.
You guys would get around town, solve crimes.
I don't think he's a cop. If he's a dog, it doesn't make him a cop.
I could become a cop.
How?
Get my PI's license.
Yeah, in a second. As a dog, I'd do it for him and give it to him. But I'd have him shadow. And what I'd do is I'd go to private investigator's school. No. And I have Marcus the dog with me and be like, shut up, Marcus. And I put glasses on and everyone's all go like, if only I could see, I could use these binoculars. Like something like that. Act super blind, like super helpless.
Right.
And the dog's going to help me. And so then Marcus is my eyes.
Yeah.
I see.
Somebody makes a good point on the chat. Can other people hear Puchinsky?
I don't think so. It seems like it's just this guy. And I wouldn't be surprised if the whole twist, if they did actually have a season, would be that it's never been talking.
I think they can hear him because he doesn't seem to talk. Well, maybe it's like a Hobbes type of situation, like Calvin and Hobbes.
Calvin and Hobbes is about Calvin's loneliness.
Yeah.
I think most comic strips are just about the writers or the painters, the drawers' loneliness.
So now that I brought this up, I have a lot of people asking this question. As a dog, Marcus, would you kiss on Wendy?
I mean, as a friend, you know, we'd have to kind of get to know each other. I don't know Wendy as a dog, like me as a dog and Wendy as a dog. Like, we'd have to, you know, hang out. Because we'd have to see how we are, like, because we have a really great human-dog relationship, but a dog-dog relationship, we have to see.
I just don't think you could understand her any better than you can understand her now.
My question is this, because
the actual dog.
If there's one thing we've learned from Puchinsky, is that Puchinsky is made horny by female humans.
That's and we've not learned dogs. That they got to that within 8 minutes.
Because well, you know what? Dude, that, you really know who phenomenal. Asked that question? Stanley Weinstein, the third Weinstein brother that just was too gross to even make it to film producing.
Right, yeah. When do they have sex? When does the dog have sex?
My question is, hear me out. My question is, does he like tits on a dog or does he like tits on a bitch? And by bitch, I mean woman. Like Stanley?
Hollywood, the moral authority of our country.
But I think Stanley Puchinsky has an affinity both for human women and for dog women.
We haven't seen any dog love yet.
But he did make a comment about it. He said the best thing about being a dog is you can just walk up to a broad and you don't have... No, it maybe.
I think he was talking about a woman.
He's talking about a woman.
Oh my god!
But you know that thing too? Could you imagine every single time? You know when like a dog noses its way into your crotch?
1990.
Like it goes up into your like balls or something and nudges around your crotch or whatever, like a big dog. I hope it's not Puchinsky all the time.
Yeah, I don't know. Now I'm sort of like really more skeptical. I'm like, oh, it doesn't know what it's doing. And then you just get it. But maybe it's a little bit more predatory than that.
Yeah, maybe.
All right.
Let's continue the travels of Puchinsky.
Honestly, and your name would be Barkus, as a lot of people say.
Oh, that's good.
Right.
This guy's not reacting. No, he is reacting.
Yeah, he can hear him.
So I think he can hear him.
Yeah, he's been talking in front of a bunch of people.
But that guy heard him. Because I think, well, before when he was talking in front of people, it was a whole bunch of hullabaloo going on.
It'd be kind of cool if the only people who could hear him are people
Hi.
With, like, schizophrenia.
We found it. We heard the scratching on the door, and there I was.
Bet you're happy Stanley's home.
Oh, I thought I'd never see him again.
Look, I know this is a little forward, but I just couldn't stand the thought of you sitting here eating peanut butter and Alpo. So we're fixing dinner.
Well, thank you, but
I love peanut
butter. You really shouldn't have.
Oh, please, it's no bother whatsoever.
Let this horny widow come in your house and make food.
It's Peanut Butter Monday, though. That's a pretty nice 1990 apartment.
Yeah, looks and brains.
Well, you're just lucky they're here.
That's the thanks I get? I'm doing you a favor. I mean, you don't need my nose to pick up the scent that this babe wants you bad.
Oh, shut up.
Pardon?
is there anything I can do to help?
Where do you keep your pots and pans?
Where do you keep your pots and pans?
See. Let's create a little mood here.
No way I can be doing that.
Why is this?
Did he find that Everybody Loves Somebody FM station?
Yes, he's a daemon. He literally has the powers to unlock many different mischievous things.
Just don't hey, dummy, not me.
It's actually a really tough acting job for the real dog. He just gets picked up a bunch.
Why don't you just strip me inside a car and roll up the windows? Find somebody
somewhere. Honestly, I think I would kill it.
So,
just put it out of his fucking misery.
I think so.
He'll be quiet soon.
Yeah, that's the thing. Yeah, Joy Vigneault says, He was talking full volume to that dog in the other room.
Right.
I'll be right back.
Why is he doing this whole thing? That's really not.
Just let him hang out.
It's a dog.
Yeah. Just let him hang out in the living room. He was doing fine. He was just putting on the stereo.
You know Puchinsky's just gonna get into trouble if you put him in the other room. You know it's where all your stuff is. It's Puchinsky. Amy Asbeck, you should just leave.
Is everything okay in here?
I'm fine, just training the dog.
Okay, we'll be in.
All right.
It's not. Yeah, okay, I think it's time for everyone to go their own
yeah,
way.
Yeah, and I brought my daughter over here with you.
Yeah.
That's the thing. All this is going off the handle. I should be more sympathetic. Try and understand. I've lost a partner, and now he's back, and then Franny's here, and. I've never had a dog before.
You're having a mental breakdown, bro.
Yeah, buddy. None of this is real. Literally none of things happened. You've gone insane. You're going to kill this woman. You're going to kill her daughter. And you're going to turn her breasts and flesh meat into
Look
a suit. And that's just how
I've
it's going to go.
I've become a dog. It's all sinking in now.
Wait, you didn't?
What?
I mean, I used to have hair on my back, but this is ridiculous.
This should have been the first
this
emotion.
This is ridiculous. This is literally what should have happened first thing.
I lost a lot more. My identity, my home, my Claire.
Yeah, buddy.
Some
you
nights
lost
we
your
just
fucking
go
wife.
What did you think was
you
happening?
You raped that
this
woman in the lobby, and you didn't even think about your
now,
wife.
All these are good for is digging up bones. Pachinski, Stan, quit feeling sorry for yourself. You got a lot to be thankful for. Sure, you're a dog, and that's different, but it's life. It's precious life. You ought to be grateful you were given a second chance.
All right.
What? What are you fucking talking about?
Everything is kind of switching here now.
You got yourself a roommate and a friend. Hey, knock it off, will you? You want to do that kind of thing, I'll get you a kitten.
He's still a tough cop, but even under all that fur.
So he got a dog, but he's not gonna get. He's gonna have to take care of the dog, but he's not gonna have any cuddles.
You've been here all night, every night.
Yeah,
week.
Because the, every
Let's
time you have to cuddle with him, they're thinking that it's Peter Boyle.
You then run along. Who needs you? You're still upset about that rabies shot, aren't you?
Yes, Davidson. All Polish people do have back hair.
We got a man.
How do you know?
Can't you smell him?
It's mostly the gun.
Yeah. Whoa.
Uh-oh.
Whoa, we gotta have some action.
Please, Chase.
Whoa. This is dangerous.
I think Puchinsky is gonna help out here.
Whoa, it's karate.
Middle East white dude fight.
Oh my god, it's fucking Warren Zevon versus Puchinsky. Whoa!
Puchinsky, get in there! Help out, buddy!
Yeah, exactly! Exactly, I called it!
My god! Didn't even knock his glasses off his face.
Didn't have to. Those are his eyes.
You know I did not enjoy that.
Yeah, good thing he's not gay. Yeah, wow.
Wow, he's got a medal.
He's got a medal.
It's really all coming together.
It's not, though.
No. That's a fun day to be an actor, Doug.
Yeah.
Although I think that was fake.
That was the
Doug.
Puppet.
That was Puppet Doug.
Tom and Harriet Banks are the lucky winners of this past week. Bob Alkaiser, Hamlet.
What do you think you're doing? It's the ninth race from Arlington. I got some money riding on it.
It's my apartment, my TV. We watch what I want.
What happened with the dinner with the widow?
I don't think that that went well.
Yes, but not equal ones.
I don't get a vote.
Not in this life.
And I'm afraid you leave me no choice.
Uh-oh.
Is he going to fart?
He's going to take a dump.
Yeah, he's going to take a dump.
My favorite.
Hey, drop it. Drop it. Drop.
Oh, it's a slipper.
Going after his
slippers. Oh, he's got the slippers. He's a dog.
They're the original odd couple.
The original odd couple.
Yeah. All right. There it is.
John Ritter was an executive producer?
I don't know if it was
what?
That
Wait,
John
go
Ritter.
Back to that. Yes, it is.
Yeah, go
what?
Back
is
to
that John
yeah,
Ritter?
Let's Let's see. Let's unpack some of these. Isn't David Kirshner like a huge name?
David
Kirk. Brian Levant, yeah, like, aren't all of these people huge names?
No, this made it on the...
No, it was just, this was just a pilot. It never aired.
He did, okay, no, David Kirshner did. He was born in 1955. He's produced the, a bunch of stuff that's no good. A television show, early 90s television show, The Addams Family, which I forgot was a thing.
Oh, yeah.
He executive produced Child's Play 3.
Okay, not a bad Child's Play.
And
not
you know,
bad.
Yes, he did. He was also original producer on Child's Play and
you know what?
An American Tale.
I forgot that John Ritter died.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, man.
So four.
Freak heart thing.
Crazy. Yeah. All right.
I've worked with the son. He's very nice.
Oh, nice.
And the guy that the last producer there, he directed The Flintstones.
Wow.
Jingle All the Way.
Wow. Sure.
Jingle All the Way is a great
way.
Movie and also has a fantastic performance from Sinbad.
Okay. Mm.
And
that's
you don't
Arnold
think so,
Schwarzenegger,
you're
I believe.
Fucking asshole.
Yeah.
And he was also executive producer on Problem Child 3.
Well, there it is.
So producer that's how talk. She got the part.
Oh, and it's Bedrock Productions, so that makes sense.
There you go.
That's
all right,
interesting.
Well, there it was. Puchinsky, the only episode that ever existed. I see why it didn't get a second episode.
No, I don't know.
There's a lot of open-ended questions there.
Exactly. Well, there's a lot of
answers.
There's a lot to unpack.
I mean, I would say, apparently someone did research. It did air.
Hmm.
It went to air. So millions of Americans saw that in 1990.
So, I just feel like there are other things you could have done, because then you could have had, like...
Well, I thought
like,
they were
you
going
You could have,
to...
like, a rapist die and jump into a cat. Mm-hmm. And then it's dog versus cat. Right? Like,
maybe, again, it never got to season two or episode two of season one.
That's,
so your disgusting
evidence.
Idea would be a possibility. And it seems like the way that those brainstorm sessions must have been going while writing that, they may have entertained that.
Puchinsky goes to the vet because he's been coughing, right? Because the thing about dogs is you don't know what happens when they're sick all the time. So you have to check every single thing. And, you know, Peter Boyle's like, oh, am I supposed to tell you how I'm feeling? I'm a dog. And so they take him to the vet. He smells cocaine. Vet has been trafficking cocaine out of the back of the veterinarian's office.
Uh-huh.
Crystal meth in the guts of dogs and cats that are brought in by the drug dealers that own them. Mm-hmm. And so it's Puchinsky in the world of dog and cat mules, some of which feel a level of loyalty towards their fathers. And they can all speak.
Sure.
And then white man.
Okay.
What was his name? The main dude in it.
No idea.
White man versus Andrew McCarthy, whatever that guy was. That guy versus like the fucking Santa Muerta, like cartel people that are also connected to the veterinary world.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just not seeing where Puchinsky's going to come in and save the day there.
He's fighting with the dogs. What happens is all these dogs are super loyal to the owners, but he flips them. Right? By the
big
people
good.
Like, we gotta stick together. We're the dogs. And then what they do is they all go and they all fucking go and they rip out the dick and balls of all of their owners and fucking stop cocaine in America. And then it shows the junkie that he caught in the very beginning, because that's what happens is that he catches a junkie the very beginning of the episode that has a bag of crystal, crank, angel dust, poppers, buzzers, and it's got paws on it.
So the very end came from a dog.
Yeah,
but
from
now,
a veterinary
how do the
office.
Dogs stay alive?
You put in plastic baggies up their ass.
Yeah, but then how do you get it out?
You fish it out.
Yeah, you put it up in there, and then you give them laxative, and then it comes back out again.
Yeah, and then you
I'm
fish
sure
it out.
I'm not sure if a dog could do that.
A dog could absolutely do that. Dog's not going to last long.
No, that's the problem. It's a lot of dead dogs on your hand. That's like a whole season of just dogs dying. But, you know.
Yeah,
there's maybe they did cover it all. I think it might have just been.
At the
very end
of the episode, that dude's now clean. And he owns one of the rescued drug mule dogs.
Yeah, that could be.
That's
could
a great
be.
Fucking episode.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I mean,
22 minutes.
22 minutes. We got to a lot. We unpacked a lot. Peter Boyle, we saw him alive. We saw him dead. We saw him doing horrible things.
Mm-hmm.
And then he was also, but then at the end, he was just a dog.
He was just a dog. He was just
slippers. Oh, wow. What a waste of an episode. You know?
Yes. It's very interesting that
I love it.
That they got all that money.
How much money do you think that cost to make?
I'd say probably between 500 and 750K, depending on how much money it was at the time. It could have been over a million.
This is the 1990s. It was harder to film back then.
But it's actual film, which is very expensive.
Right. And that automated dog was no joke. Good dog actor overall.
Yeah.
He mostly just got picked up and kind of thrown around.
Got picked up, put down, barked a couple times.
Yep. But overall, good performance. No Doug the Pug or anything like that. Yeah. The Frenchie in the news. If you're not following Huey and I'm forgetting the name of the other one. I got some t-shirts coming. So I'll wear those.
Nobody's going to care about this fact, except probably the chat. But George Newbern, the partner of Puchinsky, played the voice of Sephiroth, Final Fantasy VII's Sephiroth, in a Final Fantasy fighting game called Dissidia.
Cool.
Huh. Isn't that cool?
Very cool. What a career.
Isn't that fucking cool?
What a career.
Watched Holden play Final Fantasy
VII, specifically.
Yeah. No, we all
Sephiroth,
watched.
Sephiroth, Henry. It's just one.
I don't know, man.
I don't know. I think, if I had to work next to a dog or an animal, I think dog would be the best, or a horse.
A horse.
I would also like to work with a horse.
I think you'd do well with horses.
Yes.
Would you like to work with a horse?
Work with the horse, like the horse could have a talking role.
Working with animals is no good, man.
Why? Have you any roles with animals?
Yeah. Yeah,
what'd you do?
Animals every fucking day. They're called Ben and Marcus.
Hello? Oh, Hollywood. Hey, we got a show. Wow. Holy hell. It was our chemistry. They said they liked our roast mode.
I'm sorry. I was channeling Puchinsky. I have worked with a couple of animals. Horses are fine, but the problem is that, again, half the time you got to fucking sedate these things. Yeah. And we worked with Chimp on Wolf.
What?
And
what
they did was, so we had the real Chimp, and what they did was we all left set because they're like, just so you know, this Chimp is like close towards the end of its career. And as what do we learn about Chimps?
Yeah.
They get real angry, especially as
they
get older.
How does it know? Wait, but how do they know that it's close to the end of its career? Did it tell them, or like, how do you know when it's like he's aged out?
No, it is they reach like the age of like I want to say 3 or 4.
They reach adolescence, essentially.
Yes, they become teenagers, and then they get all wrecked up when they can't be fucking chimp women, right? Or chimp men. And so what happened was is that the story is that Leo was walking it, and it was fine because it was all be good, but it did this thing where it like looked at Leo, and like Leo looked back at it real slow, and then it snapped its other arm on Leo's arm, and then it was like, ho, and like the four different people had it come in because it was just like, because it didn't do anything, it just went and grabbed him, and Leo's just like... sitting like this. It was very intense.
Yeah, dude. If I was Leo, I would not be. I wouldn't risk it. I would not risk having a chimp tear my face off. No, I would automate a chimp.
Yeah, but I'm very scared of horses.
Ah, love horses so much.
Beautiful animals.
Very, very, very scared of horses.
Maybe a donkey or a kangaroo.
Oh, you don't want a donkey or a kangaroo. That's a dangerous animal.
I know it. I know it. I like them. Yeah,
they're dangerous. You know what I'd work with though? Couple of birds.
Oh yeah.
I also like dogs are fine. You just have to train them. Yeah. It's like, and also a lot of times, Sufi, Sully NNY says Amy Hesbeck was actually married to John Witter. So.
Yes.
In real life. They were married in real life.
Yeah.
They were married in Problem Child, in Problem Child 2, and Problem Child 3.
Yep.
That's crazy.
And they may have met on Puchinsky.
They might. Do you think they met?
Because
on Puchinsky?
No, I think that's how she got into it. Maybe.
I don't know. Or they met on it. Or
we'll report back next week.
Oh, Marianne.
Well, I've still got some videos.
All right, let's do it.
Yeah, I still got a few more videos. You talking earlier? You mentioned the Men in Black, and we said in the last episode, if you haven't listened to it, we talk about the Black Lodge. We talk about the sorts of things that come from the Black Lodge. Maybe mainly the things that keep us from connecting with each other, and the things that keep us unhappy. And we also said that Twitter comes from the Black Lodge. And of course, yeah. that means that Facebook comes from the Black Lodge.
And the New York Knicks.
Yes, and the New York Knicks.
Because I'm unhappy.
Yeah. Yeah. The New York Knicks as well. We'll go ahead and put that as a number three.
Good.
But if Facebook is from the Black Lodge, then it follows that Mark Zuckerberg is a man in black.
And well, is I have, it cool enough for that?
I have absolute proof here.
Okay.
That Mark Zuckerberg, besides, well, I mean, he doesn't wear a black, but he ticks off all the boxes for the strange behavior.
Yeah,
the weird
being a
looks,
sexless, lipless piece of shit who doesn't know how to eat right.
The pasty skin and not knowing how to communicate with humans whatsoever. Hmm. And here is a 3-minute example of that.
Wow.
Hey, everyone. We are live from my backyard, where I am smoking a brisket and some ribs.
Wow, he's just like people.
I make meats now. Smoking these meats here. Our little meat smoking. It's smoking. So, I'm the meat chef. Yeah, someone asked me, do I smoke meat? Smoking meat. Smoking these meats. Smoking meats earlier in the day. Smoking these meats. Just set the charcoal up and you set the wood chips up, and then smoking meats, grilling meats, good smoky flavor. Smoke a brisket for like 12 hours.
He's getting hungry. I mean, he's got a nice grill, that's
that
for
green,
sure.
That green egg is $1,000. It's really good, though.
Today we got a brisket on the big guy, and some pork ribs on the green egg.
You are not a person. You are not. You would stop reading off a cue card trying to describe what it
like
means to cook food in your backyard.
He's doing. This is the most human I've seen him. Honestly,
he's doing
I don't
Facebook
like it.
Live. He's
right.
launching Facebook
brisket,
Live.
And these ribs, but hopefully for Canadian.
Who are these fucking losers?
Brisket ribs. How many of you guys are eating brisket and ribs tonight?
What are you talking about?
He's talking about brisket and ribs. He's being a person.
When you hunted the animal yourself. So, what are you guys making for dinner? Brisket ribs, I hope.
No one is speaking to you.
It is not an exciting friendship.
I want to try my brisket. It's a pretty tough cut of meat. Ribs.
Have a beer, man.
Shut up, you fucking idiot.
I want my baby back ribs. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Sweet baby raised barbecue sauce. That is going on the ribs.
It is the most fucking basic.
Sweet baby raised is very good.
Fucking barbecue sauce in the world.
Just applied the sweet baby rays. Sweet baby rays.
He must. I mean,
take it from there. She's waiting for her ribs. I mean,
can you imagine him trying to eat your pussy?
No, and I don't even want to think about anything sexually about Mark Zuckerberg.
So that's pretty good.
Okay, that's kind of fun. Good. His wife is like, can you continue? Shut up.
Facebook Live is for just hanging out.
Oh, yeah.
Sitting in your backyard, waiting for your brisket and your ribs to finish smoking.
So this is the whole point of Facebook Live, huh?
Yeah.
Just for brisket and ribs? Brisket rib shows?
We need to take out these offices, man. They're dangerous.
I don't even
people.
Think that we can recommend doing that anymore.
We can't recommend doing
because
that.
Because people just do that now. Yeah.
People
got to
be scared of content creators. They gotta stop. They gotta stop. Like content creators don't flip out. Like, you know, they won't do a bunch of crazy.
I've had to edit that sentence out of so many side stories.
Yes. Yeah. It's really a message that we're really discouraging. Really hard. Really discouraging that message.
Well,
really,
it's
really
of,
hard.
Be afraid of content creators.
It's been a problematic episode
yeah,
all around.
Really
quite
saying,
honestly.
Don't go for that. Don't do that.
I mean, honestly, you're not going to win because they have robots that will just, they know you're coming.
Yeah.
Because,
I get it.
Yeah, that's it, man.
They got the big robots.
Anyway, that was actually the most human I've seen Mark Zuckerberg.
That's
I watched a TED Talk with him.
That's when he's trying really hard.
Yeah, he was
I don't
smiling,
know, buddy. I think that makes me dislike him even more. Like this idea of being like, humans make meat in their backyards with people. You know, let's go and see what they do.
I would like to see definitive proof there was actually meat in those grills. Because I could see it all just being a total lark. But I don't know. Yeah, weird. Boring. I think that's the thing. The people that are ruining the world, in actuality, they're just boring.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
all they do is just focus 100% on their stupid little project, and it happens to just be fucking all of us over.
they just have like tunnel vision where they understand that humans and interactions and like laughter and dancing do not matter. All that matters is like the pipeline up to becoming whatever is they want to whatever it is they want to be. Where Facebook has become so big and so powerful.
Right.
A part of what it is that it was literally about talking about hot chicks. That's what
I know.
Facebook
and the irony is just have an actual barbecue. You don't have to create a whole computer program. You could just have a barbecue, and then you can meet people in real life too.
Mm-hmm.
But he kind of circumvented that.
Yeah.
Let's see another one, Travis.
Yes.
Steve Jobs. He always wore black.
Crazy Bruce.
I love it.
Liquors.
We've got. I love Crazy Bruce.
Finally, something wholesome. Crazy
Bruce. He's also the number one fan of Puchinsky.
Selection and quality too.
I love it. Bald dog men.
Were too good to be true. Citadel and Cabernet, Red Merlot and Chardonnay, Crazy Bruce's liquor store.
Wow!
Yeah,
Travis. Performance.
Keep it going. Let's see another one. Let's see another one.
He didn't look so crazy, but when he was singing, it got crazy.
He has done. Let's go ahead and let's see this. He's done a good 13 of these.
Way to Crazy Bruce's. Crazy Bruce's.
What do they got there? That's an Ice House, Miller High Life.
Wine and soda and beer and spirits.
Coors Lights.
You can be sure that you'll save more. So
Bush.
Drive down to Crazy Bruce's.
Everyone's asking if he has
like
Bud Light.
Friends and neighbors do.
He kind of looks like Fred Willard. Not Fred Willard. What was the other guy that was the original McDonald guy?
Fred Willard.
Was it Fred Willard?
Yes.
George Willard. You're thinking of George Willard. They used to wish all the 100-year-old women happy birthday.
Is that George Willard?
I think it's George Willard.
No, George Willard doesn't sound right. But Fred Willard is the guy who says he's best in show.
Yeah, he's best in show.
He's like my dream. Like his performance in Best in Show is the funniest
Willard
thing.
Willard Scott from
Willard
Rookies.
Scott.
Yeah,
thank
Willard
you, Eric.
Scott.
Thank you, Eric.
That is correct. Man, you see, that's the kind of content I want to see more of. Why don't people write songs for their home businesses anymore? And go and sing them. Every once in a while, we'll have it at good, like, local LA television. There's still, like, a couple, which I like. But that's my favorite.
Well, you know, it's coming around September. There's usually some interesting 9/11 themed commercials for mattress companies or whatever it might be. They can go either way because that's sensitive area to tread on.
It's only going to get worse. The more time that comes, the more cavalier the commercials will be.
I mean, it's good for exposure. You got to sell those mattresses. You got to beat the big brands. You know, it's hard to do.
Well, speaking of commercials, let's see another local.
Oh, People's Bank. Local bankers doing local eating in the break room.
You okay, Kim?
Yes, Berry Dairy Days is coming.
Oh.
I'm going to close the store.
Diabetes. Okay. Pizza. There it is.
Member FDIC.
Yeah. What did that have to do with banking? How do I trust them to have my checking account or savings account?
Well, they're going to be at Strawberry Berry Days. So you can go, and the bank is going to have a table at Strawberry Berry Days. So you can come say hi to your local banker at Strawberry Berry Days.
Can you imagine that?
Wow.
Can you imagine going to the bank and it's just a guy being like, open your mouth. I said, open your mouth. Open your mouth. Here's your pen. And your guy just like putting strawberries in his mouth. They're just like,
Berry Days. It's
Berry Days. Berry Days and Green Days.
More start of the count? No.
Oh, speaking of food, let's see another one.
Super Mario in real life. Spaghetti!
Honestly, this guy's got a
Super
real good
Super Mario
future.
In real life. Spaghetti!
I don't even... Why would... Well, I don't... I guess he knew Italian. Italians. Yeah.
Super Mario in real life. Spaghetti!
He's very happy with himself.
Super Mario in real life. Spaghetti!
How many views does this kid have?
Oh, man.
I think that one does okay.
All right,
straight
very
up,
good.
Honestly, the better entertainment than anything we can provide.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Entertaining indeed. We don't have enough food. We gotta do more food stuff.
We could do more food stuff.
The video had 23,000.
Yeah,
23,000.
What do you mean more food stuff?
I don't know. Incorporate food more.
Why do we need to incorporate? Like, what
are you talking about? Like the way like Nadia does it? But you have to kind of be. You have to be.
No, not competitive eating. I could never compete with her. She's too good at it.
Like, you'd say we need to introduce food comedically?
Yeah, just eat. We should just eat. People like to watch other people eat. Yeah.
Wait, so you want to turn every stream into a fucking Scorsese movie? We're sitting here like eating food.
Never mind. I've seen, there was that, about 3 years ago, I don't know, every show that was like, we're going to sit around the table, we're going to eat like we're normal people, but we're celebrities. Every one of those got greenlit.
Yeah.
And they're just very uncomfortable.
This, because you have to listen to their eat sounds. And I will say that there's one thing about Matt Servito, because he's an old school actor, and old school actors all love eating and drinking in scenes because it's something to do. So, like, there's always like, Servito always walks in full Satan makeup, just going like, what if I did a thing where I got a glass of scotch, right? And I'm just kind of tinkling it around, and this thing is slipping it down. And I was like, that's your alcoholism. That's you this trying to drink scotch and stuff.
Smart guy, incorporate it.
He's very
incorporate
smart.
It. He's working, you know?
Ship him out of real life.
Spaghetti!
He's not wrong. I get it. After a hard day of plumbing, you want to have a bunch of spaghetti. Yeah.
I am fucking starving right now.
Yeah. I think plumbers must hate sauce. It's too much like the job. It's like, I don't know. They're around mucky stuff all day. I think they must like more solid foods.
Lasagnas, I would imagine that would very, very much remind them.
I don't think that any of that's true.
I don't think that they...
I bet they like a good sandwich.
Maybe they have a hard time, like, melting up a bunch of Snickers in a microwave and choking it down like it's a big turd they found in a fucking pipe.
That actually tastes pretty good, though, because that's just Snickers, really.
Spaghetti!
All right, do we have time for one more?
We've got one more, yeah. Let's take it out on this one.
Yes? It's actually very good.
It's very good.
Man, this.
Yes. Bum, 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 bum.
Too bad. The magic key. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. That's fun. Wow, that's all he had in him.
More fish singing, please.
I think that's great, man. And I'm glad that that person burnt every bridge he ever had just to get to that video.
Thanks so much for watching. We'll be back next Tuesday.
Do we have stuff to go out on? We'll be here for Comic-Con. I'm trying to figure out when those shows will be.
When the show is. But we'll see in San Diego.
We'll definitely be doing a show in San Diego.
San Diego, and you're going to see us do that bullshit. It's going to be fun.
Can't wait. Let's see what Puchinsky
looks like. We're doing two of those shows.
Yeah.
Oof. That's a lot of videos, man. That's a lot of work.